Gray County traditionally and through history has been defined by its geography, its topography, and of course the forests are a big part of that. When I go into a large old barn, I look at the timber sometimes, I stop and catch myself. It means a lot to me. There's a connection with the past there. I often catch myself sometimes when I go into my own barn even. You know, it's well over 100 years old. And I look at the timbers and I look at the size of them, the length of them, and I think, my heavens, what kind of tree, what size of tree must have that timber come out of? And you try to imagine, what was the forest like that they took those timbers from? What was the world like? It's just amazing to think about that. My father has instilled in me that it takes a long time to grow a good tree, and you don't cut one down just without thinking about what you're doing. And to me, that says a lot. There's a very strong resource there, and we need to respect that and look after it.
The county has over 40% forest cover. So what we're trying to show on county forests is if you manage it sustainably, you manage it to good forestry, you can always have a forest. Down the road, you'll have a better quality forest, better quality timber, better quality everything in it. So more wildlife, everything else. Harvesting trees is renewable. If it's done on a sustainable basis, the county has a 15-year management plan that we come back to these properties every 15 years. So we're leaving good quality trees to produce seed for the future trees in the future years.
Gray County heard about FSC certification through a number of different forestry partners, whether they be conservation authorities or other counties or private landowners, and so we were involved in some discussions on those, some information gathering, and then Carl Sadler and myself did a lot of research on what it meant, financial implications, gathering how we would go about doing that, and then a report was presented to the Planning and Community Development Committee, which oversees the county forest properties. The county was interested in pursuing it going further. Then it was a few months of gathering that information and deciding whether we went under an umbrella organization such as the Eastern Ontario Model Forest or whether the county did the certification on its own, and decided that financially and with the resources that the county has and the experience that the Eastern Ontario Model Forest has, it was much more feasible to become a partner with them under their umbrella.
There's, I don't know, 6,000 acres of crown land to the north of us. This forest is 300 acres in itself. County's owned it since probably the 50s. The key is we're trying to get a variety of sizes of timber left. The large saw logs, medium saw logs that way, small saw logs, pole wood. When we manage, we'll reduce, take out some of the trees, but still leave a variety of stems.
It's good to look after your forest. And unless the forest is well maintained and well looked after, they won't get an FSC. So if anyone is awarded an FSC, then obviously they're managing their forest in a proper way. I think the other benefit that I want to say is that it's another feather in Gray County's hat. We're the only ones in South Central Ontario that have the FSC, and I think that's that we're very proud of that.
We're standing in European larch right now, and we walk by white pine and Norway spruce and white spruce. So there's about four different sections of, you know, different stems of trees. These European larch they're phenomenal. They've done very well. And we're also taking out the odd ash that's mixed in here.
God.
Because of the MRI borer. So it's on its way, so we thought we'd reduce the seed source. We want hard maples. Now all this is ash, but there's odd hard maple in here. Sugar maple, or there's a few cherries. So that's what we want to come in, or even basswood would be great. Thank you. what we're managing is a renewable resource. So we're getting revenue for the county, but we're also, leaving the forest in better condition than we first started off. If you look around at some of these stumps, a lot of them are hollow in the middle, they're rotten. So that's the trees that markers targeted. It's the defective ones. All of them had dead tops. In the long run, 15, 30 years down the road, there's going to be some phenomenal material in here that the county will be able to enjoy for years and years.